knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Now that we understand how the heart rhythm is established, we can consider how arrhythmias in this system can occur and how pharmacology can treat them. Arrhythmias can be thought of as a binary, either being too fast, known as tachycardia, or too slow, known as bradycardia. But more important than the heart rate is the discoordination of myocyte contractility. Some important examples include atrial fibrillation and ventricular fibrillation as examples of arrhythmic tachycardia, as well as sixth sinus syndrome and conduction block as examples of bradycardia, but there are many others. Sixth sinus syndrome occurs when the SAN is damaged and no longer functions properly, such that normal automaticity set by the SAN can't be carried out. Conduction block or heart block is characterized by an incontinuity in the conductive pathways by which the action potentials of normal cardiac contractility permeate the heart tissue. These conditions generally aren't treated pharmacologically with anti-arrhythmic drugs, and pacemakers must be implanted. Other types of bradycardia are treated with beta-1 adrenoceptor agonists, which will be discussed in a future tutorial. Fibrillation occurs when the coordination of the myocytes' contractility don't rhythmically trigger the neighboring myocytes to contract in a spatially sequential way, so the myocytes quiver in a disjointed or uncoordinated manner. This can be caused by heart attack damaging the cardiac tissue or a rapid drop in blood pressure. These conditions, and ones that also contribute towards abnormal uncoordinated cardiac contraction, are the main conditions for which antiarrhythmic drugs are deployed. Antiarrhythmic drugs work by influencing the SAN and cardiac myocyte action potential through a multitude of mechanisms. These are usually thought of and organized using the Vaughan-Williams classification. This classification breaks down these drugs into four classes. These are type 1, sodium channel blockers. Type 2, beta blockers, or beta adrenoceptor antagonists. Type 3, potassium channel blockers. And type 4, calcium channel blockers. Type 1 antiarrhythmic drugs block voltage-gated sodium channels in the cardiomyocyte. This delays the phase 0 depolarization stage of the cardiac myocyte action potential, and this increase in time aids the likelihood that the rest of the action potential can be conducted in a coordinated way. Type 1 antiarrhythmic drugs are sometimes subcategorized into 1A, 1B, and 1C, based on how much they alter the effect refractory period. 1A increases the period, 1B decreases it, and 1C has no effect on the effect refractory period. These differences are mediated through the magnitude of their effect on voltage-gated sodium channel blockage, 1C having a stronger blockade than both 1B and 1A, and 1A having a stronger blockade than 1B. Class 1 drugs are used to treat tachyarrhythmias such as atrial flutter, supraventricular and ventricular tachyarrhythmias, with 1C being used primarily in emergencies for its strong blockage of voltage-gated sodium channels. Type 2 drugs are antagonists of the beta adrenoceptors. The SAN and cardiac myocytes highly express the beta-1 adrenoceptor, and antagonists at this receptor block the sympathetic innervation mediated through adrenaline and noradrenaline. Normally, adrenaline and noradrenaline activate the beta-1 receptor and cause increased heart rate, or positive chronotropy, and contractile force, or positive inotropy. Activation of the beta-1 receptor leads to an increase in intracellular C-AMP through GS-G protein coupling. C-AMP increases the functionality of the HCN channel, which increases funny sodium current, leading to increased sodium current in phase 4 of the SAN action potential. C-AMP also activates protein kinase A, which phosphorylates sites on the sarcoplasmic reticulum, which in turn increases calcium release and myosin light chain. Clearly, antagonism of the beta-1 adrenoceptor will block the effects of circulating adrenaline and sympathetic innervation, which slows heart rate and can bring about normal cardiac rhythm. It's worth noting that activation of beta-2 adrenoceptors on smooth muscle causes relaxation due to smooth muscle cells expressing myosin light chain kinase, which reduces contractility, whereas in cardiac cells, pKa directly phosphorylates myosin light chains, which increases contractility. In general, it's important to consider the cellular context and protein signaling repertoire that different specialized cells have and how they may be regulated differently from one another. Drugs in this class include atenolol, metoprolol, which is selective for beta-1, and propranolol, which is beta receptor unselective. Type 3 drugs are potassium channel blockers, which delay the action potential time of cardiomyocytes by extending repolarization phase of the action potential, phase 3. This increases the effective refractory period and is effective at treating tachyarrhythmias. If there is an uncoordinated action potential generated, the neighboring tissue may be refractory and non-conductive, which can result in normal rhythm being reestablished. An example of a class 3 antiarrhythmic is amiodarone. Type 4 drugs are calcium channel blockers. We have discussed calcium channel blockers in the context of antihypertensive drugs, which reduce blood pressure. Their effect on the heart is primarily mediated at the nodes, mainly the AVN at phase 0 depolarization mediated by calcium influx, but they also slow down phase 2 of the myocyte action potential, where there is outward potassium flow and inward calcium flow, which is inhibited by these drugs. It's worth noting that decreased calcium influx also reduces contractility through reduced binding to troponin, as discussed in previous tutorials. Calcium channel blockers reduce conductance and therefore heart rate, known as negative chronotropy, as well as contractility, or negative inotropy, of the cardiac myocytes. Some examples of class 4 antiarrhythmic drugs are verapamil, a non-dihydropyridine, and nifedipine in the dihydropyridine class. Generally, drugs like verapamil are first-line treatment for arrhythmia due to their relative selectivity on cardiac calcium channels rather than the other drugs in the dihydropyridine class due to their effect on smooth muscle cells lining blood vessels. In conclusion, antiarrhythmic drugs act to delay the cardiac action potential and contractility of the heart in the hope that normal rhythm can be reestablished in a state of cardiac arrhythmia.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.